Teachable Moment is answering the question I've been getting from a lot of teachers. I want to show my students, for example, how to use a protractor, but I don't have a document reader at home and I'm not sure how to do it, but I really want to be the one to show them. Not a problem. PowerPoint to the rescue. Because in the online pictures in PowerPoint, you can go ahead and get a protractor. Now notice I'm putting PNG because I want one that's see-through. Perfect. There's the one I want. I'm gonna select it. Boom, with a check mark. I'm gonna click insert and there it appears. Wow, it's kind of big, huh? That's okay because I've got these handles and I can make it a little bit smaller and I'm not gonna need that. Now I need an angle to measure. Easy again. Gonna go to insert, gonna go to shapes, use that arrow there. I'll draw the first line, which will go there. Wow, that's kind of thin, isn't it? I think I'm gonna make it black so it's easily visible and make it fairly heavy. Control C is gonna copy it and Control V is gonna paste it. And now, wow, look at that. I've got my angle, perfect. I'm gonna select both of those and move that over to the center. And now I can take my protractor and show my students. How can I do this? Well, number one, I could be screen sharing this screen with my students when we're in a video meeting, for example, in Microsoft Teams or in Google Hangouts, wherever. And I could, as I'm doing now, have opened up a second PowerPoint and use that all important screen recording function, which is great now because I'm using it for this. And I could record this as a lecture. So either way, it would help them out. And if I go ahead and do something like this and say, okay, well, I'm starting at zero and I'm gonna go over to 60. Let's do that. And let's insert the, the measurement of that angle, that's 60 degrees. And then if I go over to this side, how many degrees is that? Well, I have to start from zero and count over here. That's 120 degrees. And if I add those together, that's gonna give me the measurement for a straight line, which is how many degrees? That's right, 180. All the way across then is 180 degrees. And if I want my students just to see that digital inking over again, I can use Ink Replay so it can go and remind them 60 degrees, 120 degrees, and if you add them together, you get 180 degrees. Wow, check it out. We can record it as an MP4. We can use this when we're screen sharing in live meetings, and that is how you can use Microsoft PowerPoint to teach math.